Yes guys, welcome back to another video on my channel. Now, believe it or not, I've just recorded one other video and I thought, hold on a minute, there's something I need to tell people, there's something I need to tell my audience. And this is a realization which I had probably about 2 weeks ago now when I was in Thailand. I'm currently in Malaysia right now for you guys that don't know, only for the next few days and then I go back to the UK. And it was this realization about money. Now, if you're like me, if you're someone who didn't grow up with a lot of money, like I grew up in a council estate, like single parent, my mom just no father kind of thing. So I never grew up with money. Like I remember when I used to go to school and my mom used to give me maybe, me and my brother, maybe £2 a day, guys, like to get lunch and probably breakfast and dinner maybe. No, we'd have dinner at home, say. We'd have dinner at home, but to get £2 a day for school, do you know what I mean? Where I'm going to school and I'm seeing my friends with £10 a day. I remember my one friend, he'd always come in with like £10 a day, but he'd just have like loads of pound coins and stuff. And I used to think he was so rich and like, he used to like buy me like a brownie or he'd buy me like a pizza slice or something in the canteen. And like, it was just amazing. But nevertheless, the main point I want to say is I didn't grow up with a lot of money. I've never had a lot of money as of like, I'm 24 now, up until I was maybe 20, 21. When I joined the fire service was when I got into crypto, which I'm not going to talk about in this video, but that's when I started to like learn about money. That's when I started to think more kind of business mindset. I started creating custom trainers. That was my first business during lockdown and whatnot. So money was always something which, in my household, and probably still is now, like I've been away now for 3-4 months, but like money is one of them topics where if you don't have a lot of money, you feel uncomfortable talking about money. Whereas if you do have a lot of money and you do understand the psychology and the abundance about money and you get this realization moment, which I had, like I said, 2 weeks ago, which is what I'll talk about. Like money is just a thing. Like it's not a big deal. It's money is just a tool, basically. Money is something that people stress so much about, people worry about so much, but just relax. Just something that I've learned to do, just relax and just think about it logistically, like think about money a bit differently. And that's what my aim in this video is going to be for you guys. I'm just going to try and explain to you how you need to change your perception of money. You need to change how you think about money, because this is coming from someone who, like I said before, I haven't had a lot of money, guys. I might have a lot more money than some other people, but in my head, I still don't have a lot of money. The people that I look up to, the people that I watch on social media, the people that I want to aspire to be are miles ahead of me, and that's fine. There's people watching this video like yourself now who I might be miles ahead than you. Do you know what I mean? So that is why I'm making this video. And basically, 2 weeks ago, I was in the gym. And I don't know about you guys, but when I go to the gym, I always have my best thoughts, my best ideas, like my best, you know, then you get like them light bulb moments where you're just in your zone. And then like, and this is what I advise everyone to do. As soon as you get one of these moments, a new business idea, maybe you might already have a business and you've got something that you want to add to it. And you're like, I'll do that later. As soon as you get this idea, write it down. As soon as you get this kind of spark in your mind, write it down, because you'll forget about it. Same as if when you go to sleep, I always get a lot of good ideas before I go to sleep. And sometimes it makes me not be able to sleep because I'm just thinking and thinking. Write it down, come back to it in the morning. Do you know what I mean? Because these are normally the ideas and the thought processes which elevate you to the next level and to get you kind of in your business from one step to another step. And I had this thought basically, guys, in the gym. And it was the idea of like how I've always been scared of making money. Now, that might sound stupid, but if you're from where I'm from, we're conditioned to be scared. We're conditioned to not think with money in abundance. Do you know what I mean? Like we're conditioned to, that's too much money. Or maybe you want to do a new job for someone. You're a camera photographer like I am sometimes for clients, and you think, oh, I'm not going to charge that because that's too much. We're always scared of money. Do you know what I mean? Like the same thing goes for spending money as well. We're scared to spend money. And this is what I'm saying now. Like I had this mental shift in my brain about money. And basically the week prior to this, I'd spent more money in the week than I did in the last month. I bought this, coincidentally it's on my table, but I bought this new DJI Pocket Osmo 3. It's a camera, kind of like a vlogging kit kind of style camera. I bought this in that week. I spent a lot of money. I'd done a lot of things in Thailand. I ate out pretty much every night. And I spent a lot of money basically. And it's the first time I'd done that in a few months. And then I thought to myself, like in the gym, I thought, and this was like a week after I'd spent that money, I thought to myself, because I had a lot of things going for me, like basically that week. So I was thinking, I spent so much money, but the week after spending so much money, I also earned so much money. I had a video on TikTok that went absolutely viral, which I earned a decent amount of money from. I think it's like 7 million views now. So I earned decent money from that. I had some kind of, I do work in INAPA in the summer. So I had a lot of people book with me for events and stuff, which I earned commission on. More than I ever have done in the last 8 weeks. I had more of it in that week. What else did I do to earn money? I think there was one or two other things basically. I had somebody reach out to me to work with them in a different country abroad in the summer, which was a new opportunity for me. And I remember speaking to my friend on voice note, and I was saying to him, like, money is like, the more you spend, like the more you're not scared of money, the more you will attract. And I'm trying to explain this the best way I can, guys, but the week I spent so much money, in my head, like old me was thinking, crap, you've spent so much money, like what are you doing, Cam? But then the new me was thinking, wait, you've spent all this money, but now it's coming back, and it's coming back 3, 4, 5 times more. And this is the switch you need to make about money, guys. Like, scared money doesn't make money. Now, if I was you, I'd write that down somewhere, because this is something that you need to refer back to. Scared money does not make money. If you're scared to spend money, if you're scared of money in general, you will not make money. This is why the poor people, and I say the poor people or the poorer people, the people who are maybe on benefits and the people who kind of aren't in the best financial position, they don't make money because they're scared of making money. They're scared to spend money. So they save. And this is why the people in your 9-to-5s and whatever, like, they always look like, and I used to be like this, you'd always look to save money. But instead of looking how to save money, look at how to earn more money. Does that make sense? And the more money you spend, the more money you'll receive. Tip that driver that gets you the taxi. Tip your barber, you know what I mean? Like, give out money in abundance. Give, like, literally give. Give out money as much as you can. Obviously, within reason, don't be stupid. If you've got £2,000 in your bank, don't go and spend fucking 1,800, sorry for swearing, £1,800 on a TV. Do you know what I mean? Like, don't do stupid things like that, but that's just common sense. But maybe invest in that new equipment. Do you know what I mean? Maybe invest in this, because maybe invest in a camera, or maybe invest in going to that nice meal, or signing up to that nice gym, because you don't know who you're going to meet in the gym. You don't know what's going to happen when you go to the meal. You don't know if you might meet somebody on the way to the meal. Something might happen at the meal. Like, invest in good energy kind of situations, guys. Do you know what I mean? Don't just spunk your money on stupid things, on alcohol or anything like that. Just invest your money properly, because before you know it, like I said, it will come back to you in abundance. And it's very interesting when you have this mental switch. Like I said, I had it a couple of weeks ago, and if you're watching this video now, you might have it. I don't know when your time will be personally, but you might have it at some point, and I hope you do have it, because it really is an eye-opener, and it makes you not scared about money anymore. Like, I've kind of got to a position now where I know whatever's going to happen is going to happen, for one, but I know I'm never going to stress about money. Like, I'm never going to, like, deep down, we'll always be stressed about money. Everyone wants more money, of course. Everyone's always worried about going broke as such. I get it. But I'll never, like, be at a position where I'm like, crap, like, I'm not going to have any more, like, more. I'm going to go bankrupt, you know what I mean? I'm not going to have any more money. I'm going to have to go and live at my mom's house on the sofa kind of thing. Like, I know now from this process that I've been through in my mind, like, mentally, that money will always come to me. Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm not worried about money. Like, I could go out tonight and spend a lot of money on a nice meal, a nice steak. And don't get me wrong, I don't have to do that. And I probably won't do that, but I could. And I'd know that the morning after or the week after, I might make that steak back 10 times from an opportunity, or I might make a piece of content which will get me monetized, and I'd be able to earn money from the content. Or, do you know what I mean? I might find someone, or someone might message me and say, oh, by the way, mate, thanks for doing this, have this. Or someone might buy something for INAPA, and I might earn a decent amount of commission from it. So it's these little things, guys, which you need to project out into the universe. Don't be so scared about your money. Pull it out there and just kind of trust yourself and trust the process, because not a lot of people trust themselves, and that's another thing. Not a lot of people believe in themselves. And as soon as you have self-belief, as soon as you know kind of the direction you want to go in, and you know that everything's going to happen the way it's going to happen, and you know, as long as you try your hardest and as long as you put yourself in positions where you know a lot of people aren't going to put themselves because it's uncomfortable and it's not the cool thing to do, then you'll get there. Like I've been in Thailand now, I'm in Malaysia right now, like I said, but I was in Thailand for 3 months before this, and this is something that I said to myself a year ago that I wanted to do, and not a lot of people believed me when I said it. Not a lot of people thought I'd leave the fire service. Not a lot of people thought I'd start making money online. Not a lot of people thought I'd earn more money than I am right now. To be fair, I always knew I could earn more money, and I'm still, like I said, nowhere near where I want to be. But the next stage for me is 5 figures a month, and I'll be completely honest. I want to hit 10 grand a month this year, and I know I'm going to do that. But that's just because of the thought processes I have, and that is because I know the abundance about money, and I've kind of went through the process. And when you have no money, when you come from a place with no money, it makes you appreciate money a lot more. And if you're watching this video, you might not have a lot of money, but you know the value of money, and that's what you do have. You have that kind of experience, you have that knowledge that, yes, money's going to come and go, but you know that eventually you're going to be okay. Do you know what I mean? Like you know how to manage your money. And I think I'm just going to end the video there, guys. I don't want to talk too much. My throat's hurting a little bit. This video, I had no notes, nothing on my laptop. I just thought I'd sit down and just talk about it, really, because it's something which I know can give value to you guys, and it's something which helped me as well. So I thought, why not share it back with the people who follow me on YouTube? Because, like I said, my content isn't... I've gone away from the kind of fluffy editing. I've gone away from the just... too much, like giving too much in it. Like now it's just authentic, real, talking to the camera, no real kind of breaks, no real cuts or anything, unless like I stumble on my words maybe, but that's going to get better over time. Obviously I've been creating content now for over a year, so I'm not new into the game, or some would say I am new into the game. Depends on the way you look at it. But yes, guys, if you've got any questions, let me know in the comments. If you have liked this video, I'd appreciate it if you could like and subscribe to the channel. And yeah, it's going to be a good 2024. Let me know in the comments also if you've got any other video ideas, anything that you want to know about me, just reach out to me on Instagram. Whatever, I'll get back to you guys. Like, I'll happily get back to you. I'm not going to ignore anyone kind of thing. But yeah, guys, that's been it. Once again, thank you for watching, and I'll see you all on the next video. Peace.